A U.S. soldier was recently charged with killing five other military personnel at a stress clinic outside of Baghdad. And this year alone, there have been at least 11 suicides at Fort Campbell. Some speculate that post-traumatic stress disorder is to blame. On the Healthbeat, Dr. Barry Ramo tells us more about the illness.
Most of us have heard about post-traumatic stress disorder syndrome, but don't recognize the magnitude of the problem. A recent study done by the Department of the Army indicates that 1 in 8 soldiers coming back from Iraq are having findings consistent with PTSD. The symptoms of emotional instability, uncontrolled anger, depression, and anxiety result from witnessing the horrors of combat. The research indicates that fewer than half of the soldiers are getting help. Not getting help is costly because it can mean lifelong disability and unbearable emotional distress. Psychologists have found that the stress of war can be so great and emotions so intense that changes in the brain can occur, causing the victim to have flashbacks and avoid their family members and totally change their personality. They also can become completely numb to emotion and always seem anxious. During previous wars, for example, Vietnam, the post-traumatic stress disorder didn't become apparent until a couple of years after the people got home. So it's very important to recognize this problem, particularly the magnitude of it, and get treatment for our soldiers early on. For Healthbeat, I'm Dr. Barry Ramo, KOAT Action 7 News, live this morning.